One.
Hi guys, and welcome back to another video of Russia Box. And today, I can't believe it because we're gonna have three candies and, or chocolates and two cigars.
Alright, go ahead and pick the first one.
I don't even think I can reach it. Oh yeah, it's right in front of me.
Which one? This one? Oh, that? All right, ginger and cinnamon. Hold it up for everyone.
Ginger, cinnamon?
Yeah, cookies. We picked cookies.
Is this the same one?
Nope, they are different.
But they're the same shape.
They're similar, yeah. Time for tea. Russia's love affair with tea began when a Mongolian ruler gave Tsar Michael a taste in 1638. Yummy. By 1900, Russia was home to the largest tea maker in the world, and citizens were drinking it at all times. All right, let's go ahead.
Okay, this is easy. Mm-hmm.
All right, so there you go.
That was easy.
Yeah. Okay, you don't have to destroy the whole box. That's okay.
Cookies.
All right, let me open this one. It's like it's in a package.
This is like a little bit. If I put some
fat in
there,
all right. Some they're very broken. Okay. They're thin and delicate.
Oh, cute! Okay. It looks like flowers.
Try it and tell us what you think. Ginger and cinnamon. It tastes like a gingerbread cookie. This would be good in tea or coffee. Coffee, probably. Chocolate milk, hot cocoa.
Hot cocoa.
Yeah. Yummy.
I want more.
Maybe later. All right. So, I will pick the savory ones. And we tried something like that the last time, so we'll go with something a little different. Let's go with this one. Then you'll get candy after. Make it all better. So this one is Red Hot Chili Pepper Bites. We have all our candy.
I'm not trying it. I am not trying it.
There's an assumed rule that Russians don't do hot and spicy. So much so that there's a local expression to give pepper, which means to berate or punish someone. But every rule has its exception. So these are crispy, funky shaped potato crisps that are seasoned with an addictive dusting of dried red hot chili pepper. All right.
I'm going like up there so I can try.
Try just a nibble, then you'll have some water. And then you get to pick a dessert after, so. Or a
sweet
after. All right, this bag didn't open very well, but.
Let me open it.
No, you're fine, we can reach. It's like a puppy.
I don't want to eat it.
Just try a bite. They're good. They're kind of, they're not super soft puffy. They're a bit more like a Cheeto. A little bit crunchier of a puff. Those are good. I like those. They're not super hot. It's probably spicy for her, but those are delicious.
Spicy, I don't want to try it. It kind of feels like a spider in my mouth.
All right, so you get to pick the next thing. So there's these things are sweet, these are candies, and this is a dessert. Oh, you don't want to pick a dessert? Okay.
I'm picking savory.
All right.
Yeah.
So turn it around, hold
I'm
it up.
I like almost never choose a savory.
All right, yep, hold it up so everyone can see. I get the right ones here, Caroline. That one's okay.
Wait, no,
Savetsky no. Cheese potato chips. No wonder you chose it. Cheese potato chips. Time to try. Okay, stop punching. Yep, hold it still. Time to try the devil's apple. You know it better as the potato. When potatoes were imported from America in the 1700s, Russians gave them the sinful name due to their absence in the Bible. Their odd shape didn't help either. Little did they know, Tsar Nicholas would order potato planting in the 1850s, paving the way for modern Russians to use them in practically everything, from potato dumplings to vodka to these crispy chips. So let's see. Do they smell cheesy?
Wait. Not really. Mm-hmm. Must be like kind of like a cheese puff or like a light.
Whoa! Puff. They do big potato chips.
They must have ginormous potatoes. Or they must give them sideways.
Maybe. Long way, yeah. All right, try it. Tell us what you think.
Delicious.
It does taste cheesy, but it's like a Swiss, yeah. I was gonna say, the picture on the front is Swiss. I'm like, it's a strong cheese. It is Swiss cheese flavored, and you definitely get it. No more. All right. So, Mama goes next. We have tried quite a few savory. We're actually doing pretty good on that. So, I like their chocolate. I'm gonna go with this. So let's hold that up so everyone can see. Hold it nice and still. All right. That is almond white chocolate bar. Decadent white chocolate with whole almonds. It's easy to tell when it's springtime in Russia. You just have to look for the fiery hills. Okay, the hills aren't literally on fire. Phew. But they are covered with Prunus tenella, Russia's famous Fire Hill almond trees, named for their branches covered top to bottom with vibrant red flowers. Russian almonds.
There's no such thing as white chocolate.
I know. Because real chocolate comes from cocoa. And there's no cocoa in white chocolate. Just candy. Smart girl, that's my girl.
But it's the same brand as the...
Oh, is this? Yeah, this is the same brand as that, the mint lime we had the other day that was absolutely delicious. Like a mojito chocolate.
Why are you using my scissors?
So we could cut into it more easily. All right, so try a piece. That one didn't really have it here. You want to try this one instead with an almond in it? Nope. No. Okay, you won't get to try the next one then.
Yeah.
Just take a bite of the one with the almond. We can try it after. What do you think? Russian chocolate is really good. Candy is really good.
Excellent.
It's creamy. That's very, very good. I am liking the Russia box. All right. So I picked that one. We've done 1, 2, 3, 4. So you get to pick the last thing. The candy bag?
We gotta try everything in it.
Yeah. Well, it depends. Let me, this will be a good one to cut open too. You might not like this, but you can try it. It's a, don't open it yet.
What is it?
That one looks like it's a coconut thing. Let's describe that. It's coconut and white chocolate hazelnut ball. Oh, you want that one?
Okay.
You're probably going to have to suck it just for a second and then spit it out because we're not going to sit here for an hour. That is exotic fruit jellies. Ripe mango, blackcurrant mint.
Hey, this is the one that was, this is on the paper.
Blackcurrant mint and strawberry pepper. If you've completed the trivia, you already know that Russians love jelly, even when it's made of meat. Whew. Fortunately for those not so keen on trying jiggly pork, Russians also love a different kind of jelly, fruit jelly candy, locally called marmalade. All right.
Which one?
So let me read the flavors to you, and then you pick one real quick. Hopefully it's like really chewy or something. I'm thinking that is the mint one, maybe. Yep, it has a mint leaf on it.
This is strawberry.
So that's strawberry pepper.
Strawberry pepper?
Yep. So blackcurrant mint, this is probably the ripe mango. That looks like a mango. And so you've got one of each and then I don't know that.
Okay. Oh, these are actually looks like a gummy.
Okay. Here, let me cut it in half so you can. We don't have time to do. Okay. We won't. We'll save this for the next time then.
Why?
Because we don't have time.
You're really
it's chewy. A lot to chew. Yeah, that's what I figured. So this one might be a currant or a straw. This one could be strawberry pepper. I'll cut it in half.
Oh my god. Nice.
Kind of jelly in the inside. I'll let you try since it's the last one we're doing.
I can't wait.
A strawberry
that.
Pepper. Mmm. Those are good. They're soft. They're fairly soft. So that's not bad.
Jelly.
Awesome. What do you think that one tastes like?
Looks like. It's like a little pepper, mostly strawberry.
Yep, I'd agree. Very, very slight hint of pepper.
It tastes kind of like mint.
I don't quite get that, but cool. I'm gonna wrap it up.
Hope you enjoyed the video. Bye.
Bye.